have your mentor for current affairs. I hope that you all are doing really well, and let's begin the session for today without wasting any time. But the students who are coming for the first time, I would like them to subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification so that you get the instant updates about our new uploads. Also guys, you can join this Telegram group where we share free quizzes as well as resolve the queries of you guys. So don't hesitate and don't delay this process. Just join this group and the link is in the description box below. If you have any kind of query in your preparations or you need any kind of guidance from your mentor. Now, let's begin our session for the day with this first question, which is really very important for your examination. So what is India's rank in the Climate Change Performance Index 2021? So guys, first of all, you need to understand this thing that this index is for 2021, but the year is 2020. The year of assessment is 2020, and this index has been released by three organizations. So guys, these are the three organizations: German Watch, New Climate Institute, which is also in Germany, and Climate Action Network. So these three organizations have released this index, which measures the country's performance in tackling the climate change. And basically, we can say that this index measures the performance, the efforts of individual countries. Now, how many countries were assessed in this index? So the total number of 57 countries and European Union. So European Union and 57 countries were assessed in this index. And out of the total countries, India has been ranked at the 10th position. So this 10th is India's rank. Now, which country is at the top and how many parameters are there? Let's discuss that. So guys, in this slide, we have been given the parameters of this index, that is Climate Change Performance Index, and on the right hand side, we have been given a picture in which the top 10 countries are measured along with India's track record. So let's first discuss the parameters and then we will discuss the picture in detail. So the parameters are greenhouse gas emissions, which constitute the 40% weightage of this index. Then we have renewable energy, energy use and climate policy. So these are the four parameters of this index. And remember guys, this is an important index. Therefore, it is very pertinent for you guys to remember the parameters. Now let's discuss this picture. So here, in this picture, it is clearly mentioned that there were no countries on the first three ranks. So the top three ranks are empty and the top country is Sweden at the fourth rank. So remember this thing that Sweden's rank is 4 and India's rank is 10. Now apart from this, here on the right hand side, you can see India's track record. So in 2014, the rank of India was 31 and in 2020, the rank has improved to 10. So this shows how significantly India is taking measures to improve the climate change or to improve the situation of climate in India. So here this question ends and now we are moving on to the next slide. Which of the following company has launched India's first diversified REIT mutual fund? So what is REIT? REIT is Real Estate Investment Trust. Which company has launched it? It is option D, Kotak Mahindra Asset Management Company. So this company has launched this India's first diversified REIT mutual fund. So guys, what is the benefit of this REIT mutual fund? The REIT mutual fund will help the investors who are keen to invest in real estate. So this mutual fund will give diverse options to the investors. Now, what is the name of this this mutual fund? Remember this thing that the name is on the company's name. That is Kotak International REIT Fund of Funds. So that is the name of this real estate investment trust mutual fund, and this is the India's first diversified REIT mutual fund that you have to remember, and this has been launched by Kotak Mahindra Asset Management Company. Guys, can you answer the question that who is the chairman of Kotak Mahindra AMC or Kotak Mahindra Group? So this is your task to find it out and tell me in the comment section below. So here comes our third question of the day, that is which Indian has won the Asians of the Year 2020? So this Asian of the Year, it has been given by the Straits Times. So the Straits Times is a daily newspaper of Singapore and it has given this accolade, this honor to six individuals. Now who are these six individuals? Collectively these six individuals are called the Virus Busters. And out of these 6 virus busters or 6 people who are in this group, virus busters. One is an Indian, and that Indian is Adar Poonawalla. That is option A. Now, guys, he is the CEO of Serum Institute of India, that is currently developing COVID Shield. So, this COVID Shield is the vaccine that is being developed by Serum Institute of India, and because of that, Adar Poonawalla has been given this accolade, that is Asians of the Year, that is being given by Straits Times. Remember the fact that I am telling you here, because any of these fact can be asked in the examination. Now, the second question that must be triggering your mind right now is the other people who are there in this group of virus busters, right? So let's discuss that. So guys, this is the slide in which I have mentioned all the 6 people, the grouping of virus busters, and you can read it from here that first is Zhang Zhongxin. He's the Chinese researcher. Then we have China's major general, Japan's doctor, South Korean businessman, Singapore's professor, and the CEO of SII, that is Serum Institute of India. So these are the 6 people who have been granted this accolade. So that's all for this question. Now we are moving on to our next question. Who among the following is the female world athlete of the year 2020? So this female athlete of the year accolade has been given to option D, Julimar Roja. Now guys, she is an athlete from Venezuela. Now, who is the male world athlete of the year? So it is Mondo Duplantis of Sweden. So he is the man who has been given this honor of being the World Athlete of the Year 2020. So our next question is, where is the proposed Kanhalgaon Wildlife Sanctuary located? So here the first thing that you need to understand is that this Kanhalgaon is a forest that already exists. And the proposal is to upgrade this Kanhalgaon forest into a wildlife sanctuary. So now the question is, where is this located? So the right answer is option D, Maharashtra. It is located in Maharashtra. Apart from this, the Maharashtra government has also taken this decision to convert the 10 zones in the state into conservation reserves. So that is not very important for you to remember. Just remember the number, that there are a total number of 10 zones or 10 areas that have been converted into conservation zones, conservation reserves. And the other interesting fact about this question is that this Kanhalgaon Wildlife Sanctuary is going to be the 15th wildlife sanctuary of the Maharashtra. So therefore, this is important for you to remember. Now guys, can you tell me that who is the chief minister of Maharashtra? This is a very easy question. You must have known the answer of this question. Therefore, in order to trick you guys, the additional question is that who is the governor of Maharashtra? So these are the 2 questions for you today. You have to tell it in the comment section below. Now, which state has announced to transform Tharu villages into tourist hotspots? So first of all, what is this Tharu village? Tharu is a tribe which is prominently found in the lower Shivalik, in the Shivalik range of Himalayas, or we can say in the lower Himalayas. So basically in India and Nepal, the Tharu tribe reside, and in India, the majority of the Tharu tribe is in Uttarakhand, Uttar Pradesh and Bihar. So out of these 5 options, the right answer is Uttar Pradesh. It is Uttar Pradesh government that has announced to transform this Tharu villages into tourist hotspots. Now, what is the importance? Why does the Uttar Pradesh government need to transform Tharu villages into tourist hotspots? First reason is to promote the cultural heritage of Tharu tribe. And second reason is that the majority of the scheduled tribes that are there in Uttar Pradesh are, or we can say, belong to the Tharu tribe. So therefore, this Tharu tribe constitutes an important part of Uttar Pradesh. And therefore, in order to develop the Tharu people, this initiative has been taken by Uttar Pradesh government. Now, let's have a look at the culture of Tharu people in this slide. So this is a very beautiful and interesting picture that I have found, and I have presented it here in front of you guys. So this picture, these ladies are from the Tharu tribe, and this is a glimpse of Tharu culture that the Uttar Pradesh government aims to promote. So guys, that's all for today's session. I hope that you have really enjoyed the session, and if you have, then do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification as well. Thank you so much for watching the video.